www.radiomirchi.com.
Yes, the last topic of this chapter is frustum of a cone. The last topic of this chapter, surface areas and volumes, is frustum of a cone. Frustum of a cone. What is a frustum? A frustum is obtained when we are removing a small conical part from the top of a larger cone. From a larger cone, we are removing a small conical part. The remaining part is called frustum of a cone. Frustum of a cone. This is the shape of frustum of a cone. This is frustum of a cone. We are removing a small cone from the top part of the cone. Now, this is small r, radius of the top, and this is capital R, radius of the lower part, and this is height h of the frustum, and this is slant height L, slant height of the frustum. There are some formulae related to this also. First of all, we are writing the formula for finding the slant height of the frustum. Slant height L is equal to root of h square plus capital R minus small r the whole square. Capital R means a radius of the broader part, and small r means a radius of the smaller end. Capital R minus small r the whole square plus h square is the formula for finding slant height L of the frustum of a cone. Now, curved surface area of frustum is equal to, formula is pi L into capital R plus small r. Pi L into capital R plus small r is the curved surface area of the frustum. Then total surface area of the frustum. Total surface area of frustum is equal to CSA plus area of two end faces. Area of two end faces. This is the total surface area. CSA, we have already written the CSA, pi L into R plus R. Pi L into R plus R. Then plus area of two end faces, pi capital R square plus pi small r square. This is the total surface area of the frustum. Now, there is one more formula, volume of frustum. Volume of a frustum. Formula is pi h by 3 into capital R square plus small r square plus capital R into small r. These are the formulae in the frustum of a cone. First of all, we have to find out the slant height. Slant height L of a frustum is equal to root of h square. Here h means height of the frustum. H square plus capital R minus small r the whole square. CSA of frustum is equal to pi L into R plus R. Here L is the slant height, and TSA of frustum is equal to CSA plus area of two end faces, means CSA plus area of this face, larger face, plus area of smaller face. We have to add CSA and areas of two these end faces. Now we will obtain the total surface area of the frustum. Therefore, TSA of frustum, total surface area of frustum, is equal to pi L into R plus R, that is the curved surface area. Now, pi R square is the area of the larger face, and pi small r square is the area of the smaller face. Now, volume of a frustum, volume of frustum is equal to pi H by 3 into capital R square plus small r square plus capital R into small r. H is the height of the frustum, and capital R is the radius of the larger face, small r is the radius of the smaller face. Capital R is the radius of the larger face, small r is the radius of the smaller face. So, study all these formulae thoroughly. Now, we can do any problems based on the frustum. Okay.